I went back to the toxic 1v1 court where I played, you guessed it, 94 overall pure post scores. So who do you think won? Stay tuned and watch this video. And now we have Slasher Takeover versus Rim Protector. Who do you think won? Let's find out. Before the video starts, if you guys are looking to buy a stacked NBA 2K19 account with high overall and maxed out badges, go to sportstnb.com. I'll leave it in the description, the most reliable account seller out there, SportsTNB. Alright YouTube, it's Quill, and I'm coming back at you with a new video, and we are on the toxic 1v1 court. First game, a two-way slasher. He does have a negative record, but we have to remember that he has defense in his build. So let's see what we can do. I want you guys to pay very, very close attention to all four gameplays I have in this video. This first gameplay against this two-way slasher, already you see what I'm doing to him. It's already not looking good for this man. Something happens this game and in game three that is really, really funny. So you guys definitely should stay tuned, find out. Game two, you guys should just watch. I had a really good game. I got some really, really crazy dunks. And game four is the one that I showed you guys in the intro against that very toxic post score. So stay tuned and see what happens when I play against a 94 post score with a good record. And I haven't mentioned already, but please, hit that like button. Let's try and get 1,000 likes on this video, as oh man, I just violated this man. It doesn't matter if you have defense in your build, because you're going to get dunked on no matter what when I have my takeover. He does end up getting the ball back. I forget what happened. He was on a little bit of a run. But the difference between me and him is, let's see how he scores his buckets. First one, I'll give him credit. It was a good dunk he got by me. This one, I mean, he got a good animation that should go in. He is a slasher, I understand. Remember, I do have silver defensive badges. And this one, look it. You're telling me I jump at the perfect time. I feel like my fingertips hit that ball and it somehow goes in. Any type of build with lock in it, I feel like is just super overpowered. I'm just like, there's no way he gets it again. So I go down there, put my hands up, get a stop. And this is when I start getting some crazy dunks. Game two, I get some insane dunks, but one thing you guys are going to notice throughout this gameplay and a lot of my future gameplays is the amount of people that literally just sit in the paint and spam X. It's really starting to get annoying, but I'm telling you guys, all you have to do to stop a slasher is, look at him, just tapping X and getting a steal, getting a foul. I played about 8 or 9 games on this 1v1 court right here, and I don't want to ruin anything because you guys are going to see in these gameplays, but I'm telling you guys, all people do is spam X, and right, how is that out of bounds on me? How is that out of bounds on me? I give him space, he gets a little mid, he goes for a contact layup, misses it. And I'm like, okay, 14-8, let me start going crazy. And oh my god, put him on the ground. I just dunked on this man, both of us fall to the ground. This man goes, he ends up slapping the floor. And now look what happens. This man just quit the game after I dunked on him. This was so funny. I couldn't believe it. I ended the game 22-8. And then the second game right here, a 96 Elite 3 small forward sharpshooting shot creator. You see his record. He's close to 3,000 wins. So he's definitely good. And just watch what I do to this man. First play, I just assert my dominance, contact dunk, boom. 2-0, easy contact dunk. I'm thinking, this man's a sharp shooting shot creator. I should either get by him, or I should get a contact dunk on him every play. It's like playing a stretch big. When I play stretches, they get dunked on just every single play. So you guys see, I'm cooking him. Oh my god, let's slow-mo that. He thought I was going, look, what are you jumping at? What are you jumping at? I just killed him with that hop step dunk. And you guys are gonna see me do that dunk a lot. I started just doing that hop step on this court, and I'm telling you guys, it started killing people. I got some really good clips. This man, at this point, I have my takeover. There's really nothing that he can do to stop me, right? That's what you would think. But as of right now, I'm just getting by him with ease until, like I said, slasher takeover is not as OP as post score, as lock, but First possession, he accidentally does a pull-up. I get the ball right back, and I still have my takeover. So you guys already know what time it is. I'm trying to get him to go in the paint so I could dunk on him. And right here, I just know, we go right back to the hop step dunk, and oh my god, where are you going? What are you jumping at? Once again, this man is jumping at Casper the Ghost. He doesn't know where he's going. He doesn't know where I'm going. I killed him once again with that hop step dunk. That just looks so crazy when you actually slow mode. I do it one more time. I just hop behind him, dunk. He realizes he can't stop me. This is when everybody just starts spamming X, but you can't spam X when I do a Euro. Boom, Euro right by him. 18-0. This point is looking like a 22-0. He has a cold ring. I'm trying to get a contact dunk. 20-0. And just look what happens. After this, I end up winning the game. But just watch what happens. You know, I just want to end the game 20-0. Get a little quick 22-0. And this man gets a lucky block. Don't worry, I ended the game. He gets off the cold ring, but I did end the game. I just didn't put the clip in there. And then right here, game three, a sharp shooting rim protector, which with once again almost 3K wins, another elite three. First possession, pulling up from three. I have my confidence up. Boom. Second possession, I do the same thing, but I brick. But you guys already see, I'm playing against a sharp shooting rim protector. Rim protectors, locks, any type of lock in your build, you think you're gonna, oh my god, one more time. I killed that man with the hop dunk again. I've been killing people with that move. In these next two possessions, I'm pretty sure I did get blocked and then just get the ball back, get a lucky putback. I'll admit, it's lucky, but let's be real. This dude's a rim protector. How do you expect me to actually score on him? I'm trying to do the hop dunk. He blocks it. I get a lucky rebound. Go right back up with it. And I know, one more make, I get my takeover. He has his rim protector badge. I kill him with the behind the back move. Boom. Takeover time. It's takeover time. You guys already know what I do with my takeover. This is what I showed you guys in the intro. Pure slasher takeover versus rim protector takeover. I dunk on him. And then he quits, just like the first guy. I get a contact dunk on him, and then he quits. I couldn't believe it. So right here, I end the game, boom. And now, we're getting to what I showed you in the intro. The toxic post score. You guys saw it in the intro, 94 overall pure post score. But on the first play, he gets me a good move. I'll give him credit, hell of a move. But he misses a wide open layup. I get in front of him, I crab and get in front of him. Easy dunk. And now all I'm thinking to myself is, I can't give this man the ball back. He's a post scorer. There's no way I give him the ball back. And for some reason, he thought holding B was going to stop me. But in all reality, if you guys go against a slasher, do not hold B. And look at him. After he missed that post fade, he was like, I got to get my takeover up. Starts going for some cold shoulders. I actually start boxing him. Get the green layup. And look at the top right. Look at my takeover meter. One layup or dunk off a takeover. That's all I need. And I just know this game is over. There's no way he can stop me. And I go right back to it. The nice hop dunk. At this point, I have my takeover. And you guys know what time it is when I have my takeover. I killed this man with a spin move. I don't know what he was doing. He went for a charge. I spin around him and I dunk. That was a crazy move. That's a really underrated move, the spin dunk. I really like it, but a lot of times it gives you layups and it's not really that good for clips. But you guys see, I have takeover. Nice crossover move, and he gets a lucky block and then his layup goes in. That's what I'm talking about. I killed him. Slasher takeover. I'm right by him and the game gives me a dunk that he can block. I feel like as a slasher, there is no way that he should be able to actually block me if I have my slasher takeover and I get in front of him. There should be no way. He keeps holding me. I don't know why. I end this game real soon. Just pay attention to what happens. But please, if you guys are still watching, then that either means one, you really enjoyed the video, which if you did enjoy the video, do me a favor, smash that like button. 1,000 likes on this video for some more slasher gameplay. I don't know if I'll go back to the 1v1 court. I'll play twos, I don't know, but smash that like button if you did enjoy the gameplay. Hit that sub button if you are new to the channel. If you're still watching and you're new, I do upload slasher gameplays pretty much weekly. So even though it's coming to the end of 2K19, I will be making a slasher in 2K20. I will be making a point guard in 2K20, whatever it is. I'm gonna be grinding. Make sure you sub if you haven't. Make sure you leave a like on the video if you haven't. Hope you guys enjoyed this gameplay. All four of these gameplays of me destroying these toxic tryhards. And I'm out.